Friends, welcome to youtube.com Obric Dr. Vaid channel. I am Dr. P.R. Patel, Professor and Head of Veterinary Medicine. We are going to discuss important bacterial disease of cattle and buffaloes, bovine genital campylobacteriosis, part 4, last part. In this last part, we will discuss differential diagnosis, treatment and prevention aspects. Friends, we discuss differential diagnosis of bovine genital campylobacteriosis. The campylobacteriosis causes abortion. Similarly, there are few infectious diseases also causes abortion. So here we will see some of the important feature for the differential diagnosis. One disease is infectious bovine rhinotracheitis. There is a placentitis, necrotizing vasculitis in the placenta. Abortion at the 4th month onwards and necrotic foci in the liver. Another important disease is brucellosis, caused by Brucella abortus. Abortion in the last trimester of the pregnancy, 6 months onwards, characterized by retention of placenta, chronic endometritis, and can be diagnosed by agglutination test. Continue with the differential diagnosis. Trichomoniasis is caused by Trichomonas fetus, characterized by retention of placenta, pyometra. Abortion in early part, that is 2 to 4 months of pregnancy. This trichomoniasis can be diagnosed by hanging drop method, by examination of the urine exudate, and clinician can find a motile trichomonas fetus by hanging drop method. It can be confirmed by agglutination test. Another disease is leptospirosis, caused by Leptospira pomona. Abortion, pregnancy above 6 months, the cotyledons are yellowish brown color, and Leptospira can be examined by dark field microscopic examination of samples and can be confirmed by agglutination test. Continue with the differential diagnosis. Listeriosis, caused by Listeria monocytogenes. Abortion occur around 7 months of pregnancy. Here there is extensive autolysis of the fetus, characteristic. Along with abortion, listeriosis is a septicemic disease, so signs of septicemia is observed, can be confirmed by the agglutination test. Certain fungi causes abortion, called mycotic abortions, caused by fungus. There is characteristic necrotizing placentitis. The cotyledons are enlarged. Abortion 4 months onward pregnancy. Characteristic finding and confirmation is that microscopy examination of placenta shows characteristic fungal hyphae. By this way we can diagnose the mycotic abortion. We discussed the treatment aspect of bovine genital campylobacteriosis. Streptomycin is a highly effective drug in bulls. The parenteral injections of streptomycin are given. Just the two injections of streptomycin is sufficient to eliminate the infection from the bull. Further, the bull can be treated with streptomycin in oil suspension, and this suspension can be applied to the penis and prepuce for 3 days. That can clear the infection in about 3 days. Continuation of the treatment aspect. Bulls are treated, but cows are not treated. There are some practical purposes. Because nowadays, artificial insemination is compulsory, and almost all are using artificial insemination. Artificial insemination is an excellent method for prevention and control of this genital campylobacteriosis. So cow doesn't require any treatment or preventive measures for practical purpose. Prevention aspect. Vaccination is adequate to protect at the time of export. Vaccination is very important for prevention of disease also. The vaccination of the herd twice prior to the breeding season to increase the high serum IgG titer. So important thing is vaccination done. Vaccination is good for the prevention, and vaccination of the breeding herd two times prior to the breeding season is very important for the prevention of the disease. We continue the discussion on prevention. Annual booster vaccination is required, because the serum antibody titer decreases very rapidly after the vaccination. So vaccination is required annually to maintain the antibody titer. Vaccination of both bulls and females is also essential to completely eliminate the infection. Disease in farm or herd produce immunity in animals. So there are sometimes automatic cure is also observed because of the immunity caused by disease in the farm. Continuation of the discussion of prevention. Friends, remember, nowadays artificial insemination is followed intensively all over the world. And that is the only successful method for prevention of this bovine genital campylobacteriosis. So artificial insemination is a must to prevent the disease. Biosecurity, especially proper disinfection of artificial equipment, is very much important. During artificial insemination, the semen should not be infected, otherwise it may spread the disease. So semen must be pure, clean, without infection. Personal hygiene is also very important for the prevention of disease. Friends, we have discussed all aspects of bovine genital campylobacteriosis in a very easy, nice way, one can understand very practically and easily. Request you to share this information to veterinary friends and students, to promote the channel, to subscribe the channel. Thank you very much for observing this video.